Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's look at setting repeating calendar events and reminders. So you may already know how to create an event in Calendar. There are lots of different ways to do it. You can use the plus button up here. You can just double click inside of the date and then name the event and set the time. Then you can also set repeat here. And there are a lot of different options. Many of these options are not available if you're using iOS, but if you're syncing with iCloud, like should be, then you can set these repeatable events on the calendar app on your Mac, and then they will show up and work properly on iOS. So here under repeat, you can see I can have it set to none. It's just a regular event. I can have a repeat every day at the same time, every week on the same day at the same time, every month on the same date at the same time, or even every year. So for instance, if I change it to every month, I can set a end date. So I can say, oh, I only want it to go till the end of this year or next year or something like that. So you have some options. You can also go to custom and you can really customize it here. So you can set it to monthly and you can actually change it and say, I want this to be every other month or every third month, which could be really useful for lots of household chores and tasks and things like that. And I can have it be say, multiple days. So I can say, I want it to repeat every month. I want it to be the 3rd and the 19th and the 23rd of every month. Or I could switch away from that and say, I want it to be on the first Tuesday or first day or first weekday, first end day. Also, it's 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, and last. You really have all the options possible here for customizing how things will repeat. So let's look at some examples. Suppose, for instance, I want to set it to weekly. And I want it to be every week, so every 1 week, on, let's say, both Monday and Friday to remind me to do something. And you can see it does it like that. I could change that by clicking on it and change it to something like annually. So every year, and I can have certain months I want to select. So say I wanted to do it a quarterly kind of thing, where I wanted to remind me to say check my smoke detectors in the house. So I can say, okay, January, April, July, and October on the, let's say, first weekend day, so the first Saturday of each of these months to remind me. And then I can set it with an alarm to remind me to do something to, you know, say, check the smoke alarms. And it works out really nice that I could be able to do this and customize things so precisely here so that I can have these repeatable events in the calendar as just one thing here. So let's say I've done this. I've set this up, and let's take a look here and find out what we've got going on. So here we are, October 1st, check the smoke alarm. Great. Let's go here to January, and there it is. January 1st, which is Sunday, check the smoke alarm. And we look in April, and April is also the first day on a weekend. But if we go to July, we also have that on Saturday. And let's say that I want to turn this off after this date here. So I can actually select this. I'm going to hit the delete key on my keyboard. And I'm going to say delete only this event. So for instance, I'm not going to go and do it this time. Or I can say delete all future events. So now that one is gone and any ones in the future. But if I go back, I can see it's still set for July 1st.